Hey everyone, my name is Stephen Poitras, Solutions Architect here at Nutanix, and today we're going to be talking a little bit about data protection and how that's managed on the Nutanix platform. So as we mentioned in the prior session, the op log is essentially a persistent write buffer which is stored on SSD. When a new incoming write comes in, it's going to be facilitated by the local node's CVM and thus the local op log. So in this example, say I write piece of data A, that's going to be stored on the local op log. From there, we synchronously replicate that to another node's op log within the cluster before we acknowledge the write. This ensures that if a node were to go down, or if this node were to go down, I would still have another copy of the data within the cluster. So this is a typical example of an RF2 or dual copy scenario for data. However, say for example, I write data B, which is configured to be RF3 or N+2. Essentially, what would happen is it's going to be written to the local op log and then synchronously replicated to two op logs before the actual write's acknowledged. Once both remote op logs have actually acknowledged the write, then I will come back and actually acknowledge that the write has been completed. In this case, I actually have three copies of the data. So if I were to lose a node, I would actually still have two copies of the data which would be available. As we previously mentioned, the op log is really a persistent write buffer which allows us to handle bursts of random writes, coalesce them, and then sequentially drain them on the back end. So in this example, if we have data A and B here, that would then be drained down into our extent store. In here, I would have my copies of A and B. Similar over here. One of the key things to highlight here is during the synchronous replication for the data protection in the op log, all nodes within the cluster participate. There is no mirroring, there is no pairing, or anything like that. So if I were to have an 8-node cluster and write 7 chunks of data here to this node 1, all other of the 7 nodes would actually handle one of those remote replications. So that's one of the key things when we start talking about the scale-out performance, is as I actually scale out my cluster, I actually scale out the number of remote op logs and controllers which can actually facilitate those replication requests. Another one of the key things in terms of data protection is ensuring data quality. In this example where I write both A and B, when the write actually occurs, I take a checksum of that data. That checksum is then stored in the metadata. And the key thing with that is whenever I read a piece of data, say for example here I wrote data A to node 1, and I want to perform a read request for this piece of data, what I'll do is before the read is actually returned to the virtual machine or hypervisor, I'll actually perform a checksum and check that against what is actually stored in the metadata. If it's stored, meaning the data is what I expect it to be, I'll directly return it. However, in the case where the checksums do not match, I would actually go to one of the remote nodes which stored that data, perform the same process again, perform the checksum, validate it against the metadata, then before I return the data to the VM. This is extremely important when we start talking about data quality. It's not just about storing the data persistently, but it's also about ensuring that the quality of the data and consistency is there. We also perform things in terms of proactive scrubbing on the disk devices. This includes our curator framework, which will actually scan through, check all sectors on the actual physical disk devices, and perform proactive scrubbing. So this concludes data protection on the Nutanix platform. Thanks for watching.